धीरज, आई एम ऑडिबल टू यू?
सो हेलो एवरीबॉडी, माई सेल्फ धीरज फ्रॉम क्लास 8. सो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे माई टॉपिक इज फादर. फादर इज अ मेल पेरेंट ऑफ अ चाइल्ड बिसाइड्स द परपेंडिकुलर बैंक बोन्स ऑफ अ फादर to his children. The father may have a legal and a social relationship with the child that carries with the
Okay, I think some network issues with Dheeraj. We'll reconnect with him once he rejoins back. Okay, second one, who wants to deliver lecture it now? Samiksha, Krishna, Ashish, Naman, anyone? Hope I am audible to you all. Naman?
Yes, sir. You are audible.
Okay, so who wants to go next? No one ready?
Sir.
Yes, Samiksha, you are ready? Hello, Samiksha, not ready? Should I call your names now? I think no one is showing similar eagerness as shown by Dheeraj. Naman, are you ready with your topic?
Yes, sir. I am audible to you.
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir. I am ready, but I would want to wait for someone. Why? Because I would coming fast and I would not want to tell something. Yeah, after 20. Yeah, I am prepared with my topic, but at the present time, I hope my friends are some tell and then I will. Awesome. Hi.
Okay. Any other speaker? Krishna, why there is hesitancy to go first? See, it is very good to have very first narration. Anna, you don't have any thoughts around circulating in your mind. You are very fresh and just feel that confidence. Rest of the speakers will speak. Okay, Krishna, you are ready now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Krishna. Just little bit loud. Your voice is very low.
With the view that world like ideal moment, the union, peace and congress of the universe is other and disgrace value of high one. And in some
Krishna, Krishna, just somewhat loud. We are not able to hear you clearly. Can deliver it again.
Yes, sir. Good evening, everyone. Today is my news about standard mole. In bone bushes, the dew that work like its. It is a real most. It universe is an concrete of the many universe, each which are despair value of high mass, and in some of the universe the high bones is like in the molecules universe, which is having bones collapse in a big curse in a very short time. When understand with a high bones universe is collapse over paired day universe world view on one of the very light heavy universe. What's movement? The mole, which include two new plates in date to the no prepared for by the standard mode. Thank you, sir.
Okay, what is your word for the day, Krishna? You have not told the word.
Sir, despair. Despair means of and this kind.
Okay, despair. Okay, very fine. Krishna, I think you need some more confidence in your talk. I previously also mentioned that the fluency is not that. We could not connect and we could not take some meaning out of what you are talking. Okay, so just little bit confidence in your voice and the two sentences you connect after the full stop. Just try to see the proper words, proper conjunctions, so that it sees that and we could get proper meaning out of it. Okay, Krishna?
Okay, sir.
Okay. Okay, we'll be the next now.
Sir, can I speak?
Yes, yes, Om. Please.
Sir, I am a Gayatri.
Yes, Gayatri. Go on.
Hello, good evening, friends and sir and ma'am. Dreams. Dreams ete artha sentence. She has a big dream for the beginning of famous singer.
Bihari the peacock is a national bird and tiger. It is national animal of India. Mango is a national fruit and lotus is a national of India. The national anthem of my country is Jana Gana Mana and national song is Vande Mataram. My country and a rectangle plaited national flag. I am proud of my country. Thank you, sir.
Okay, Gayatri, my country and your country is India. It is very proud feeling when we hear this name, we hear this word India as an Indian or in Marathi, Bharatiya. So it is very proud feeling when you hear this word. And it is good to know that you have covered everything. What is our national animal, national bird, and national anthem and all. Do you know what is the ratio of our tricolor flag? As you mentioned, it is a rectangle. It is particularly some measurement is there, particularly there is one ratio. In that only it should be created. Do you know that, Gayatri? Okay, anyone else knows that?
Yes, sir. I know about it.
Yes, Naman?
Sir, 3:2.
Yes, sir. Know about it.
Yes, 3:2, right. And she also mentioned about our national anthem. So in how many seconds it should be finished?
Sir, 52 seconds for national anthem and 65 seconds for national song.
Right, right. 52 seconds for national anthem. Okay. Good, Gayatri. We will be the next now.
Sir, can I?
Yes, Vaishnavi.
Good evening, everyone. Today's my word is flagrant. Its meaning is shocking because it is done in a very obvious way and shows no respect for people, laws, etc. And today's my topic is pulse polio. Pulse polio is an immunization campaign.
Actually, we're not audible.
So just a second, I check my.
Tejas, I think she is audible.
Okay, maybe some network issues. Till Vaishnavi gets good network, we'll be heading to our next speaker. Will be the next speaker now? Vaishnavi, you there?
Sir, am I audible now?
She is audible to me. What about others? Faces, you can't hear?
I can hear you, sir. I am not hearing Vaishnavi.
Okay, Vaishnavi, try and speak.
Good evening, everyone. Today's my topic is pulse polio.
Just hold on. Others, someone to acknowledge? Anybody is hearing her?
Yes, sir. She is audible.
No. Tejas, I think problem at your end.
Okay, sir. Okay, Vaishnavi.
Go ahead.
Good evening, everyone. Today's my topic is pulse polio. Pulse polio is an immunization campaign established by the government of India to eliminate poliomyelitis in India by vaccinating all children under the age of 5 years. Against the polio virus, the project fights polio through a large-scale pulse vaccination program and monitoring for polio causes. India vaccination against polio started on 1985 with expanded program on immunization. By 1999, it covered around 60% of infants, giving 3 doses of OPV to each. In 1985. The Universal Immunization Program was launched to cover all the districts of the country. UIP became a part of Child Survival and Safe Motherhood Program in 1992 and Reproductive and Child Health Program in 1997. This program led to a significant increase in coverage up to 5%. The number of reported cases of polio also declined from thousands during 1987 to 42 in 2010. Children in some areas of India are weaker and often had diarrhea, which reduced the efficiency of the vaccine. Open defecation, monsoon flooding, and a lack of water treatment made it easier for children to swallow more polio virus. As a result, children with too few doses of vaccine were not fully protected, and sometimes. Got polio. So it is important to take pulse polio vaccination. Thank you.
Okay, very well covered. Pulse polio, yes, very important, and it should be taken at very childhood age. Very well brought out and very well covered whatever the main years of that particular pulse polio program and how we have achieved the target of immunization. Good, Vaishnavi. Good flow and good confidence also. And very well covered by knowledge perspective also. Okay. We'll be the next now.
May I, sir?
Yes, Komal. You can go on now.
Good evening, everyone. Today's my new word is urbanization. Urbanization means include more areas in cities or expand the city. Today's my topic is national movement. The national movement of the 19th century is the sole reason why India exists as an independent nation today. The nationalism in India rose due to the influence of the French Renaissance and the subsequent French Revolution. The traditional India identity has its roots deep into the ancient era. Hence, 200 years of colonial rule led to the rise of several political, socio-cultural, and economic unrest throughout the various princely states. Igniting the fire is the masses led to the eventual creation of the Indian National Congress. Hence, it became the cause of the rise of nationalism in India. Causes of Indian national movement. Indian leads a life of oppression under British rule. They wanted to get rid of the torture of the moreover, some of the reform unknowingly became responsible for uniting the vision of the colonist people. The British brought about the political unification of India. The country was supposed to have a common administrative framework, one judicial system, and one set of laws. The development of the transport system connected people throughout the country, new roads connecting all the regions, the introduction to the railway, the telegraph, and the faster postal system. Western education was the biggest boon of the British Raj, although it was introduced in India to make faithful servants of the out of the people. It leads to the revolution of mind. Great leaders like Rajaram Mohan Roy, Dadabhai Nauroji, Swami Vivekanand, and others were born. They revolutionized the millions of youth of the country towards the path of logic and liberty. The birth of Indian press and newspapers was a weapon to inject the seeds of patriotism, nationalism, and freedom into the minds of the people. Now, the message of nationalism was spread without the knowledge of the Britishers. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Good, Komal. Your word was urbanization, yes. And your topic was national movement, yes. So if you look at India's national movement, so it has been a very unique and very different from rest of the world, and it has been various contribution, as you have highlighted, from various leaders, also the contribution of press and newspapers you have highlighted. So very good. It is just thing that see, there was always we have promoted peace. But at some times in the Indian national movement, we required some countermeasures, physical force, use of physical force. So we have been seeing now Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose statue being there erected at the national, at the India Gate. So see, all the heroes had their different contributions to the Indian national movement, and some of our historical books do not cover that, but it is very important that we keep remembering our heroes, and we should feel proud in our Indian national movement struggle. Yes, okay. Good, Komal. Now, who will be the next speaker?
Yes, there is one new student, Amok. Amok, can you hear me?
Yes, yes, uncle.
Amok, you introduce yourself, and I believe you are prepared for one topic.
Yes, uncle, I have.
Okay, do one thing, you introduce, and you can then narrate your topic. Tejas, you can take over.
Yes, Amok, yes, as sir said, you can introduce, and then you can go for your topic.
Yes, sir. Sir, my name is Amok, and sir, I belong to Delhi. Sir, I'm around 15. I'm 15 years old, sir. I'm in class 10. Sir, now can I tell my topic, sir?
Yes, Amok. Yes.
Sir, I want to speak about how does social media affect our country's youth, sir. Social media, sir, has asserted its dominance over the internet, sir, in just a span of few years, sir. Social media, sir, it is used by almost everyone, sir, even youngest people, middle-aged people, almost everyone. And it's really important to supervise what type of content teenagers consume over the internet, as whatever they consume, they aspire to become the same. So social media has both pros and cons as well, as everyone has. So basically the pros are that social media, it helps you connect better to everyone. Social media also, you know, it relaxes stress basically over the youth. It relaxes stress, and it also helps you helps you generalize your work. It helps you to connect people better. Now when we talk about the pros, social media has always had its dominance only on the basically on the youth. Social media also sir, can I have a minute, sir?
Yes,
sir. Sir, I'm not prepared it, sir. I'm just thinking and speaking.
No problem. You can switch over to Hindi also if some words if you are not recollecting.
No problem. I'll just have a minute.
Amok, be comfortable. You are very good. It's going well. You're confident. Just relax and be very, very natural.
Okay, I think he left. Once he reconnects, we will reconnect
Hello.
To him. Yes, Amok. Yes, Amok, you can speak. I am audible to you.
Hello.
Yes, Amok, yes, proceed.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, Amok, please proceed.
Hello, am I audible, sir?
Yes, Amok, you are audible. I am audible to you.
Yeah. So I was talking about the pros and cons of social media. Now the cons are like basically social media youth has always been about spreading rumors about everyone. Now social media can be really harmful for those. Like social media, people spread rumors about everyone on social media. They can spread in a gif, and that person can get insulted too. So social media has always
No issues, Amog. It is that, just relax, okay? Your flow was very good and the points you are bringing in was also good. It is very hard to recollect for me also sometimes when it goes very sudden and natural. So it is not a thing of worry, okay, Amog? And you talked about social media, its pros and cons. Yes, definitely. And as you mentioned that it has been mostly affecting youth, yes. Because why we are as a teenager, we are not having that sense to know that particular what will be the right for us and what will be the wrong for us. So sometimes in the usage of social media, we get we shoot our overtime and we will get more into that bad things, bad habits, and we'll be insulting our friends. Will be not liking. It is a fun. It is a app. Some apps are there for entertainment. But it is that we should be making judicious use of social media. And in a broader context now, as you mentioned, it is a very symbol of connecting to the world. Now at your fingertips, every information in the world is available to you through social media. There is no need to particularly read through long newspapers and headlines. All the headlines will be shortlisted and made up to your preference. So it is very good, but overuse and it is not good overuse. So we should be concentrating how judiciously one can use, and particularly youth should be taking lessons from that. Okay, Amok, just relax and stay focused. Tomorrow's session, you can come prepared and speak. Okay, Amok?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, no worries. Will be the next speaker now?
Sir, can I?
Yes, Yashvi. Yashvi, you are there?
Sir, can I?
Sir, may I?
Okay, Aradhya, you can go on.
Good evening all. I am going to tell you about weather. The thick layer of air surrounding Earth is known as the atmosphere. The atmospheric conditions do not remain some on all days. It changes from hours to hours and day to day. The atmospheric conditions of a particular place at a particular time is called weather.
Okay, Aradhya, you finished with your topic, weather. Okay, so there is one difference between weather and climate. So Aradhya has lastly mentioned that a particular climate of that particular day and particular time, so we call it weather. But when there is a periodic cloudings or particular weather phenomena over a period, over a span of particularly, I think, 7 days, so we term it as climate of that particular region. Okay. Okay, good, Aradhya. Who will be the next speaker now? Yes, Samiksha, you can speak.
Yes, sir.
After Samiksha, Tanay.
Sir, my voice is coming.
Yes, Samiksha.
Good evening, everyone. My today's new word is emperors. That means a ruler of an empire. So my today's topic is on martial arts. Firstly, I would like to tell all of you that I am also a karate player. And our father of and god is Bruce Lee. The real name of Bruce Lee is Lee Chen Fan. Bruce Lee was a Chinese martial art instructor. Bruce Lee was born in America, California, in San Francisco Hospital on 27th November 1940. So basically in karate there are many types of karate like kung fu, budo, bushu, shotokan and many more. We have a total 11 belts. The basic level is white belt and last level is black belt. The main motto of karate is to self-defense, discipline, mature the child, health purpose and etc. The history of karate was karate involved in East India over a period of centuries, becoming systemized on Okinawa in the 17th century, probably by peoples forbidden to carry weapons. It was important in Japan in the 19th-20th century. Several schools and systems developed, each favoring somewhat different technique and training methods. What is karate known for? Karate is Japanese martial arts whose physical aspects seek the development of defensive and counteracting body movements. The themes of traditional karate training are fighting and self-defense. Through its mental and moral aspects, target the overall improvement of the individual. Karate comes from the word kara, means empty, and ti means hand. It's mean empty hand. The and second fact was the first style of karate was started on Okinawa. Though karate has roots in self-defense and disciplines, it also used by many as a fitness workout that adds to their own exercise demand. The father of modern karate, Funakoshi Gichin, was born in 10th, 1868 in Yamagawa, Shuri, Okinawa Prefecture. He was in a samurai lineage from a family which is former times had been a vassal of Ryukyu, intensity nobles. By age 11, he had already made a name for himself in Ryukyu style martial arts. Formulaic Japanese is taught by a part of karate's technique, practiced as the language of performance and rituals and values as the key indicator of karate expertise over the other languages. Karateki is the formal Japanese name for the traditional uniform used for karate practice and competition. Karategi is somewhat similar to the judo, as there shares a common origin. However, the martial arts and court, the uniform is generally much lighter than loose fitting. Karate is martial art developed in Ryukyu Kingdom. It developed from indigenous Ryukyuan martial arts under the influence of Chinese martial arts, particularly Fujian white crane. Thank you, sir. I have done all.
Okay, Samiksha, you spoke on martial arts and that too focused mainly on karate. Okay, so very great form of martial art, karate, which has origin in Japan, as you brought out, is definitely, and the main motive is that self-defense. The main motive is not to attack someone. The main motive is to defend ourselves. And particularly as a girl, as a woman, you should be having a knowledge of these and learnings of these. Anything, any martial art which will be helping you to self-defend yourself in any adversities there. Okay, good. Well spoken, Samiksha. The flow was very good and confidence was also good. And the knowledge you have gained, you keep it very long and also try to read it continuously so that it gets into your mind. Okay, who will be the next speaker now?
Sir, I.
Yes, Tanay.
Good evening, friends. My today's topic is the little boy. Little boy was the codename for the type of atomic bomb dropped on the Japanese city of Hiroshima on 6th August 1945 during World War II. It was first nuclear weapon used in warfare. The bomb was dropped by the Boeing B-29 Super Fortress, piloted by Enola Gay, Colonel Paul Tibbets, junior commander of the 509th Composite Group of the United States Army Air Forces. It exploded with an energy of approximately 15 tons of TNT and caused widespread death and destruction throughout the city. The Hiroshima bombing was the second man-made nuclear explosion in history after the Trinity nuclear test. Little Boy was developed by Lieutenant Commander Francis Burke Group at the Manhattan Project's Los Alamos Laboratory during World War II, a reworking of their unsuccessful Thin Man nuclear bomb. So in my opinion, it was good to drop a bomb on Japan because that time Japan was aggressively expanding its territory and to put an end to Pacific, and World War II, US has dropped a bomb on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Thank you, sir.
Tanay, dropping a nuclear bomb could never be a solution to any conflicts. Okay, you know what were the after effects of dropping a nuclear bomb on this Hiroshima and Nagasaki. You know that their generations had suffered. Okay, so they have brought out lessons, and it was lessons for complete world also. But this mindset should not be there. If someone is very aggressive, there are very other measures to cope up with that, to meet that adversaries. But to go to such extremes where we are harming the innocent lives of that Japanese peoples and their upcoming generations also, who have not seen world, what was their fault? So it is not very good and very practicable solution, I feel. Okay, Tanay, just change your perspective. Never go for such extreme extreme solutions. Okay, we'll be the next speaker now. check the list. Ashish, you want to speak? Dheeraj, you want to speak again?
Ashish.
Hello, yes sir, I can speak.
Yes, Ashish, go on.
Yes, sir, very, very good. Good evening to everyone. Today's my word is noise. Noise means newly. Hindi meaning is nausikhya. And today's my topic is entrepreneur. Entrepreneur is a person who making a...
Yeah.
Entrepreneur is a person who making his own business, taking risk, taking financial risk. And Tilak Mehta is the youngest entrepreneur in India, and he's making personal paper company, and his history of making, his inspiration of making a personal paper company is his he forgotten his book, math book, in his uncle's house, and then the price of speed post is more than his book price, and this is the inspiration of he, and he started his parcel and paper company, and many of his company's net worth is this time 100 crore, and his monthly income is 8 crore, and he's the in this time he's in class 10th in Gurukul Olympiad School in Maharashtra. Thanks, sir.
Okay, so you gave one example and your topic was entrepreneur. So entrepreneur in general is a source of employment, and in today's scenario where the jobs are very less, we are encouraging our young graduates or the students to look for more and more entrepreneurship opportunities, not to opt for job but to create jobs, and in future these entrepreneurs will be very helpful, very vital, will be playing very vital role in growing our economy. We know some of the very classic examples of entrepreneurs, you know, recently there is acquisition of Air India by the Tata Industries, and the entrepreneur, the well-known entrepreneur Ratan Tata, you all know. So we are in need of these private sector, private entrepreneurs to run our governments, to create jobs for our peoples. Okay, good. Will be the next speaker now? Dheeraj, you want to speak again? There is one person, Dilip Kumar Shukla. You want to introduce?
Yes, sir. No, sir. My name is Aman Kumar Shukla.
Okay. Okay, just introduce and whatever topic you have prepared, go for that.
Okay, Bhaiya. I started our topic. Hello, good evening, all of you. My name is Aman Kumar Shukla. Today's my word is criticize. Criticize means someone indicate the fault of someone or something, means kisi ki ninda karna. Today's my topic is co-education. Co-education means that teaches to the both boys and girls are in the same school and under the same room. It also means impart of the same education, of the same of it is it also means the impart of the same education to the both success without any distinctions. The system of co-education aims at bring boys and girls together. So I next is Who was started to co-education? The great Greek philosopher Plato has started the co-education in ancient times. He believed that co-education create a feeling of comradeship between boys and girls. Yes, Plato has a great supporter of education to the women. Yes, therefore he wanted them to educate with men in the same institution. So next is advantages of co-education. There are many advantages of co-education. The advantages of co-education is boy and girls are taught together. There will not to be any need for opening for separate school for boys and girls. Co-education is the economically system because boy and girls are studying in the same school and they can be taught in the same staff. So next is disadvantages of co-education. Here there are some disadvantages of co-education. Of course, certain conservation of people criticize the system of co-education. Yes, according to them, the system of co-education was against to our tradition. They also fear to our co-education will the education. Yes sir, they also fear to this co-education will develop immemorable relationship between boys and girls. They believed in this co-education both the boys and girls will be spoiled. Today's my topic was and thankful to all of you.
Okay Aman, very naturally spoken about co-education. See, in the today's world, we have seen many girls, many women are working shoulder to shoulder in many industries, many various sectors, and they are actually leading that particular sector. They are not just shouldering men, but they are actually leading that particular sector. So it is very important, and it is that one of the advantages of co-education. Yes, you have rightly brought out, if the boys and girls are studying together, so there will be less expenditure on the infrastructure and the teachers required for that, different schools for different for girls and boys. But at the same time, the biggest advantage of co-education according to me is that it narrows down social gap between the men and women, the boys and girls. When right from your age, one sees girls sitting next to you, so there is no such gender discrimination when you grow up, and you treat them equal. You feel that they are an integral part of our system, and to develop as a nation, sir always says 50% the share of women will be very much essential in the future, coming future. And you have seen many institutions, particularly talking about the army, the defense forces, we have now started admitting the women in the frontline forces. So it is very good, and it is the very advantage of co-education. Some disadvantages you mentioned were not very appropriate, Aman. Okay, just okay. Try to relook into it. Okay, we'll be okay. The next speaker now.
So can I speak? Papa can kaam kara jis chala saath mein.
Shikant.
No sir, my name is Prabhat Sukla.
Yes, okay.
Thank you, sir. So, firstly, very very good evening to all of you. Today my topic is corona disease. So recently this is a very harmful disease. The corona are infected in this cases, there are certain types of there are many person are die there are many person are die there are many person are die. There are certain types of things are good in corona, and there are certain types of things are bad. Like as economic status are down in India, and the poor man of the poor man of India are face many types of many types of problems in our life, and the cases of corona, the government apply lockdown. In this lockdown, the education was very education is very affected, and the student are not study in this lockdown, and they are going certain types of ways, like as gaming and playing Free Fire and the lockdown affected the occupation of poor person, and they are affected many types of person in India, and the corona is a one type of virus, and virus are included microorganism, and I am saying some types of a line of a virus. Virus is a cellular organism. The virus is a cellular organism, means no any types of cells in virus, they are a cellular. In biological, the cell are not a living thing, but they are one microorganism, and they are living another person, another living organism cells, and survive another living cells organisms. Thank you, sir.
Okay, your name is Vaibhav.
No, sir, my name is Prabhat Shukla.
Okay, Prabhat. There is one extension of Hindi letter A in your every word. So some corrections or some improvement is needed. For that, you just can practice loud reading, very loud reading of English, and see the pronunciations. You have now Google. So there is an app, a Google Translator, or just on Google Chrome or any other browser, you can have that particularly mic symbol, where you can see that what exactly pronunciations are of particular words. Okay, so it will improve your pronunciations. Also, it will build in some confidence. So loud reading, you practice loud reading every day, at least over 2 times a day. Okay. Okay, Prabhat.
Yeah, may I speak?
Yes, sir.
And you talked about corona. Yes, it is the biggest now we have seen by recognized by many names like SARS-CoV-2 or COVID-19. So it is the biggest threat, and particularly as a young people, we are getting disconnected with our education. We have now been forced to pursue the online education. So yes, so there are various disadvantages we have been facing now, and our poor sections of that particular society are getting very badly affected with this lockdown kind of situations. Okay, so
भैया मैं स्पीक
नमन यस नमन
ओके सो वेरी वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल द जेंटलमैन अकॉर्डिंग टू डेली एक्टिविटीज आई वुड वांट टू मेंशन माय मीनिंग गैलेंट्री गैलेंट्री मींस होता है वीर सौरता सो नाउ टुडेज माय टॉपिक इज अबाउट द गैलेंट्री अवार्ड्स So first of all, the thing is that I'd want to mention some of the topics regarding to gallantry awards. It means which types of a criteria that these types of awards will be have given. So it is related to the defense staff. It means whenever you related to any army, navy, air force. So and you do the some great works. As like I'd also want to mention two of the thing that there are two types of award, which is including in the gallantry award. First is wartime award. And second is peacetime award. So number by number, I would want to mention them. So as well as on the other hand, we talk about gallantry award. So in gallantry award, there is a wartime. It is a three things. The first is Paramvir Chakra, and second is Mahavir Chakra, and third is Vir Chakra. So some of the topics and some of the things I would want to tell about the Paramvir Chakra and then all the things. So yeah, the Paramvir Chakra, it is the largest and most conspicuous bravery award which is given to any personnel of the our country. So the thing is that it is a wartime. It means why these types of a prize will be given to another person. So the thing is that we have taken an instance to understand this thing. Okay. So means you are going the border and you do the fight with your enemies. Okay, so you want to win there. So our Indian government will be take these types of prizes to our defense personnel for encouraging them. And there's a many personnel who will be think to take these types of a thing. Yeah, so this is about Paramvir Chakra. And now we have want to talk about the second wartime award, which is given to the army personnel or the defense personnel. So second is Mahavir Chakra. Yeah, it is also award which is given to the persons related to a defense, but it is the second largest. And it is also a posthumously award which has been given to the person. So the means of posthumously, I hope some of the people or the students who know about it. So I want to tell about this thing in some brief. So the thing is that whenever you are dead, okay. So but in your past time, you have do some great work. So our government will be nominated them and take this award to their families, to all the their relations. So yeah, this is the means of posthumously Manohar Puran Puraskar unhe diya jata hai. And now we have want to talk about a third, Veer Chakra. Yeah, it is also award which is given to the personnel who sacrifices their lives during the fights. Yes, and it is the smallest. It means in the wartime. Yeah, but according to them, it is a great. But whenever we want to talk about the numbers, yeah, it is the third largest award which is given to the peoples or defense staff. Now it is time to talk about the peacetime award which is given to the personnel. So yeah, the thing is that what is the difference between the wartime and the peacetime? So the peacetime is that you do the great works. Yeah, you would do the great works regarding to all the fields, but not in the fighting. It means not in the at the time of a border. Yeah, you do the great work in all the criteria of the defense staff, but not in the fighting occurred thing. So yeah, this is the peacetime thing. And in the peacetime, there's a three award, which is Ashok Chakra and Kriti Chakra, and now the last is Saur Chakra. So I'd also want to mention some of the topics regarding to this thing. Yeah, the Ashok Chakra is the award which is given to the all the persons which is like to army, navy, air force. And yeah, the second is Kirti Chakra. It is also given to posthumously award to all the it means which have any people who has nominated them. And the third is Saur Chakra. It is also given to the persons similar to Veer Chakra. Yeah, so these are all the things that I would also want to mention that the Somnath Sarma, Major Somnath Sarma is the first Indian people who want to take a Mahavir Chakra. And also Vikram Batra, and we have taken inspired that whenever we want to talk about a Vikram Batra, we learn him from the Operation Vijay, and also regarding to Kargil, that he is the most brilliant person or the what we say it is less for him. So yeah, these are all the things, and according to my opinion, all the defense staff will be think about this thing. that one day he also want to reach at that point and taking that also award. And whenever they have been think about it, so they will want to do their all the efforts for serving their country. Yeah, so this is my opinion. And Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Okay, Naman, the confidence as always. And very well covered the gallantry awards, wartime and peacetime. One correction, Major Somnath Sharma is the first recipient of which award, Naman?
Sir, Paramvir Chakra, I hope.
Yes, Paramvir Chakra. You, while you are delivering, you mentioned Mahavir Chakra, okay. So in the flow, you may have probably missed it, okay.
Yeah, yes, sir.
In the next session, as Naman has brought out the gallantry awards, I want everyone in the next session, everyone should be giving one name of Paramvir Chakra awardee, okay, all of you. Along with your letters, along with your words, you should be giving one name of the recipient, the Paramvir Chakra, okay?
Yes, sir.
I think everyone has been covered. Anyone left?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Dilip, you are there, okay. You can go on. Dilip, you are
left
for
Om,
you are there, okay.
Om,
yes.
Sir, my speak was completed.
Okay, Om.
Yes, sir, I'm speak. Hello friends, good evening. Today I'm talking shirts about Guru Purnima, Guru, one of the most important celebrate festival of the India, Guru Purnima. It is festival of the Hindus and Gurus. As well, Guru Purnima is a festival which the dedicated to the your Guru. A Guru is not only as the knowledge by also shared the right pair. Guru Purnima is a festival of the Ishas, the dedicated to the Gurus. His festival of the festival of the scheduled the respect Gurus. The festival of the celebrated according to the Hindus calendar, which is the one of the first moon day of the Ashar moon and connecting to the English calendar in the month of the July, celebrated year of the July. Thank you, sir.
Okay, Om, Guru Purnima, yes, a very important festival, we could say, where we respect and remember our gurus, our teachers, and to my belief, Guru can be anyone. Your elder sister, elder brother, your parents, your teachers, or any in the surrounding. Anyone can be the Guru who, from who you get good lessons to progress in your life. Okay, so it is very important to have and celebrate and remember our Gurus and pay tribute to them every year or wherever we feel to do so. Not on a particular day, but every time.
Tejas, voice is breaking.
Okay, maybe some network issues. Sanjay sir, I would like to come. I'd like to ask you to come in.
Okay. I'm outside, so I'm not switching on my video. Very good. I want to reiterate one thing, that what we are doing in the evening, 8 to 9, 1 hour is a big thing. It is a quality time. Everyone should remember that with every passing day, with every day, with one practice, what you speak, what you are gaining. It should not be a wasteful thing. Firstly, at individual level, you must improve every day. One word is added to your vocabulary. It is up to you how seriously you take. Secondly, pronunciations. Some of you require a lot of working on it. It will happen. It is a journey. It has started. You will pronounce it well. Who knows, one of you will be greatest orator tomorrow. Secondly, the knowledge. Different topics people are preparing. You all are very, very young kids, right from 4th standard till 10th standard. So you are preparing as per your choice, as per your understanding, and as per your exposure. So it is good. And every topic is welcome. You may have solid knowledge of any topic. You are covering it here. For lifelong, it will be a great thing. Then comes a communication standard, which is improving every day, which is important. You must improve. You must feel that improvement. Every day, you must feel about it. Okay, how I have spoken today? Was there enough confidence? 1 month back, how I was speaking? Today, is there any improvement? So like this, you must be analyzing. Fortunately, technology is helping us. You can review your own performances on YouTube recorded video. So this video is put up on YouTube. At times we miss it because of some technical issue, but mostly we are trying and putting it on YouTube. So why it is done? Because you must listen to your own part, how it is coming up. And whatever topic, whether it is social, political, or at international level, military topic, generally some of you are very interested about defense because you are aspirant for NDA. That is a great thing. You are slowly preparing and heading towards NDA or CDS, whatever destination comes your way. You want to become doctor, engineer, IAS, IPS, defense officer, whatever you want to become. The one thing is required is your personality. So you must focus that this 1 hour is not going waste. It is fruitfully utilized. Listen carefully. You speak 1 or 2 minutes or 3 minutes. That should be a quality practice. Just focus on that. Okay. Overall, it was a very good session, Tejas. Over to you.
Yes, sir. Yes. Okay. So as rightly mentioned by sir, analysis of your performance is very important if you want to progress. Okay. So now the facilities of recorded sessions is available on the YouTube. So you just can review your performance of how you spoke today, how you spoke tomorrow, and how you are speaking a week after or a month after. So it should be that the progress should be seen and felt by yourself. Okay. So a very good session. And I am leaving you all with one task. I want the names of Paramvir Chakra awardee, one names from each one of you in the next session. Okay. So good to have you all here. Jai Hind. Good night.
Jai Hind, Jai Bharat, Bhaiya.
Jai Hind, Jai Bharat, Bhaiya.
Jai Hind, sir.
Jai Hind, Jai Bharat, Bhaiya.